am I happy? That's the one question I have asked myself the most during 2020. In the spring, when we had the lockdown period here in Helsinki, I was staying all alone in my tiny apartment, working remotely from there, eating all my meals there, and pretty much staying indoors the whole time. Being confined to that small space really brought forward the love-hate relationship I have with asking questions. I love the feeling I can get when I ask a question and get to learn something new or connect with people in a new way. On the other hand, I hate some of the feelings that questions may bring with them. The anxiety of not knowing whether the answer will be yes or no. The irrational fear I sometimes get when I'm walking on the street and start to wonder, oh no, did I lock the front door? And the feeling of emptiness and being without a direction I have sometimes felt when I have thought about my life and have had no idea where it's going. Am I happy? This question helped me realize something. Even though I don't like some of the unpleasant feelings that questions may bring with them, asking questions is not something we should avoid, because asking questions is the perfect tool each one of us has at our disposal to really learn who we are as persons and where is it that we want to go in our lives. Could people be happier if they asked more questions? Well, I realized that I certainly could be. In the spring, when I asked myself, am I happy, I was able to make some real improvements in my life. At work, I realized that I had been taking care of my tasks just fine, but I had not really paid attention to the kind of career I would like to have and what kind of tasks do I enjoy. I realized that I would like to work more closely with our customers as I was now doing quite solitary work with my laptop. When I realized this and talked it over with my team lead, we were able to modify my role a bit so that now I'm doing both the analytical work I enjoy with my laptop as well as working more closely with our customers. That's a demo effect for you. In my free time, I realized that I was not happy with the amount of time I was spending on... Let's see if this works. On the amount of time I was spending staying connected with my friends and family. When I realized this, I started to take weekly time to have videos with my friends and family to really stay connected, even though we couldn't be in the same physical space. Finally, I realized that I was somewhat unhappy with the amount of time I was spending on myself and improving myself, especially how much I was doing sports. When I really started to take the time, I was able to find again the love I have for exercising and running, and I'm now in better shape than I've been in quite some time. Let me ask all of you now a question. Have you had something in your mind that you have been unable to ask from someone? Maybe from a family member, a friend, a colleague, or yourself? Why is it that asking questions can be so hard? Well, no one really teaches us how to deal with all of those unpleasant feelings that questions may bring with them. And that's why it's important to really stop paying that much attention to them. But you can relate to these feelings. Picture yourself now in this large auditorium. There's hundreds of people there, and you have just heard an interesting lecture. It's time for questions. Slowly, you start to raise your hand, only to realize that, oh no, nobody else is doing this with me. Right at that time, you are picked out from the crowd and zoom, you have hundreds of eye pairs staring straight at you. On that simple one question, you can feel some serious pressure now. But you shouldn't worry about this pressure or the other unpleasant feelings that questions may bring with them. They will pass, they can't really hurt you. But the things you might learn after you have asked a question could be invaluable to your lives. You might be hoping for some tips on how asking questions could be made easier. I can offer you this. It's just like running. At first, every step of the way might feel like an absolute torment. But after you start taking those steps, it will get easier. You will get better at asking questions, and you stop paying attention to all of those unpleasant feelings and really enjoy all of the learning and discoveries you can make. We all have a limited amount of time here on this earth, and I want to use mine as well as possible to help others and live the best life for myself. Asking questions has helped me do both of those. So please, don't be afraid to ask questions. Go with it and start to deal with those feelings. Because it all starts with one simple question. Am I happy? That was the one question that got me started on my journey. Am I happy? That's the question that helps me make decisions each day. Am I happy? That truly is the one question for me. To this end, I'd like to ask all of you, what's keeping you from asking your questions? Thank you.